The earthquakes and the tsunamis which we now face are in a very complex way helping the process of awakening. How they actually affect is not so important to understand, but what is important is to know that in a very complex way they are helping the process of awakening. New Zealand, by its unique location, has a definite role to play. All nations have a role to play depending on their physical location, and New Zealand has a different physical location down there, and it has to play a very important role because every part of the globe has to be awakened for a global transformation. And we will certainly be helping people to face these calamities. As I once said, if you are a trainer or a blessing giver, certainly no matter what the tsunami is, what the earthquake is, you will be saved, you will be helped. So we will be going all out to help all those people who are caught up in these calamities. All the blessings are with you.
Next question, Bhagwan. See, Bhagwan, when you say everything happens automatically, do you mean when in the awakened state? Is it also all happening automatically for unawakened people too? I am concerned that we all do nothing because we sit back and say, well, it all happens automatically and I have to be helpless so the divine can take over. Is the world in the state it's in because the mind believes it is in control, and if the mind could accept everything was happening automatically, would be awakened?
Whether you are awakened or unawakened, all things happen automatically. These teachings are there not to be practiced. You cannot practice and see things happening automatically or sit back and say all things are happening automatically. Once you are awakened, you see that all things are happening automatically. Not that you sit back and keep quiet. You'll be most active once you are awakened. But you see things as though they are happening automatically. These teachings are not to be practiced at all. They are there only to help you realize that you are awakened, or better still, that you are not awakened. If you were to practice these teachings, you get into serious trouble because they cannot be practiced.
Thank you, Bhagwan. Yes, Sri Bhagwan. What do you see and feel about New Zealand and its people at this present point in time? Are there any specific things other than giving blessings that we can do to help the country?
Besides its a strategic location, I think a lot of work has to be done with the indigenous people. That would be a great contribution to global awakening.
Thank you, Bhagwan. Dear Bhagwan, why do I enjoy suffering so much that I can't give it up?
That's because of what happened to you while you are being born. Maybe moments before you are delivered, something must have happened, because of which you seem to have got addicted to suffering. But this can be rectified.
Thank you, Bhagwan. Dear Bhagwan, please explain the interplay between the descent of the divine and the opening of the chakras and the rise of Kundalini energy of the Sushumna Nadi to the Sahasrara chakra and the awakening process.
As the Kundalini rises and opens up every chakra, it is the equivalent of opening up parts of the brain. Each chakra is like a switch for a particular part of the brain. As the Kundalini rises and moves into the chakra and activates the chakra, that part of the brain is activated. And more the brain is activated, the greater is the descent of the divine. So on the one hand there is the ascent of the Kundalini, and on the other hand is the descent of the divine. That's why you have two triangles, one coming down and one going up. And they do meet in what's called the Sahasrara chakra, and then it again comes down and stabilizes itself in the Muladhara. Not that it must always be at the Sahasrara. At the Sahasrara the meeting occurs, and then there's a gradual coming down, and it sets down the Muladhara. Thereafter, it's like you going into a peak state and then coming down, but not coming down to the bottom line, but somewhere in between and staying put there. But much talk of this is of no use. It has to be experienced.